Y'all know I got Patrick Mahomes on my fantasy football team. He went down last Thursday night against the Broncos. They said he's going to be out for a couple of weeks, but I know he's already back at practice, so maybe he'll only wind up having to miss a week or, you know, two, because they were originally saying 3 weeks. Matt Moore came in. They wound up getting the win still. But, you know, it's going to be a rough next couple of weeks, and when you're trying to fight with the New England Patriots for that home field, this is not sitting well for the Chiefs. But do you guys think that they can win the next two games without Patrick Mahomes?
Andy Reid is a good enough coach to come up with a game plan. And even though Pat is out, Matt Moore is a solid veteran. He's been around. He's played some games. They've got enough weapons. I think they got to use this time now to develop their running game again.
Yeah.
They got to get that going a little bit. But the scary part, and I think,
well,
you're going to have to develop it.
Well,
Damian Williams, you know, you brought in Shady McCoy to go with Damian Williams. Now you're going to have to start force-feeding them guys.
Try to make a trade for Melvin Gordon, maybe.
I highly doubt the Chargers would trade Gordon within the division. Doesn't matter how bad the Chargers are. I'm not helping the Chiefs. Yeah. But I think that they've got to get back to running the ball a little bit now. And I think if you're Andy Reid, I don't like the fact that they had him practicing, I'm be honest. I think that's a sign of we're going to try to rush you back and get you back in the groove of things.
Yeah.
Let him rest. He's already on a bum ankle. Mm-hmm. Now he had a dislocated knee. You're really playing with fire right now if you rush him back and he gets something. He gets hurt worse than he's already injured now.
I mean, it showed when he was hurt a couple games before he got hurt again.
Yeah,
so
last couple of games.
You could tell that he's injury prone. We don't want another Kevin Durant situation in the NBA.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So
that's what you see. The first couple of games was like Herculean games. Then like the last three, he kind of slowed. He was like normal.
And defense got to show up. I mean, the defense to me is the
concern.
Defense
is terrible.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, the defense is terrible.
I think Andy Reid is going to do a good job of letting Matt Moore feel comfortable in the offense. But the defense, I just don't think they can hold up.
Somebody
got
to do something on the defensive end.
That's why I say you've got to use this time now to get some sort of confidence in the running game. I'm not saying those guys are going to come out and start running for 200 yards. But you've got to get a little something going. Because if you think that just throwing the ball up and down the field is going to translate to the playoffs, it's not.
Yeah,
teams are going to slow down the game on you,
mm-hmm.
and you've got to be able to find rest for your defense. Because if we're going to see that defense on the field for 8, 9, 10 minute drives, they're losing. They're not. Yeah. Their defense isn't good enough to sustain those type of drives. So they've got to get back to running the ball. They've got to find a way to build the confidence in the offensive line. You know, when Mahomes got hurt, it wasn't just a clean shot on him. It was the fact that the O-line just kept getting pushed back into him.
Yeah,
they've got to build confidence up again. And these next 2 weeks are your opportunity to build that confidence back up.
Yeah, I mean, they're fortunate that they did actually win that Broncos game, because that would have been bad for them had they lost that game. But their record, you know, going in already having one of the better records in the league and being able to kind of get that victory actually helped them out a lot over these next couple of weeks if you don't have Patrick Mahomes. You know, so they got to try at least, I mean, if he misses the next two games, they got to at least go 1-1. Because if they go 0-2, it's going to be hard for them to catch the Patriots. You know, at this point, because, I mean, they're looking unstoppable.
Yeah, if they go 0-2, not only are they're not catching the Patriots, I don't think, but then you're not getting a bye either. You're playing that first, playing that wild card weekend, and now you're adding another opportunity for Patrick Mahomes to have to be in the line of fire and more mileage on his legs, and also your defense the opportunity to be exposed another week. Their best case scenario is to try to get to that number two seed like they did last year, have the one home game where it's very tough to play an Arrowhead, and then you take your chances. But if they got to go on the road.
They were the number one seed last year.
Number one seed, sorry.
Yeah.
So they want to be one of those top two seeds, though. And so if they've got to play wild card weekend, again, you're looking at a rematch with the Texans, who already know how to beat you.
Mm-hmm.
A rematch possibly with the Colts, a team that knows how to beat you. A rematch or a game against a Buffalo team that has a very tough defense.
Yeah, and you don't even know where you're playing at because it's not
you may not be playing at home.
Game.
You may
and,
not
and
be
and
playing
these
at
teams
home.
These past few weeks, the Colts, the Texans, they showed how you beat the Chiefs, which is keep Pat Mahomes off the bench.
If you rush Pat Mahomes,
he's going to be on the bench, all right? Because he's not going to be playing.
Ain't going to hold up.
Exactly.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right.
This is Deion Grant from the New York Giants, Super Bowl champ. And you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
Live from the camp. This is Real Fans Real Talk. Real Fans Real Talk. We as real as you thought. Real Fans.